Okay, so our next section, section 7, which remained uncovered during our workshop. So I have made two questions over here, and we'll be solving these two questions. The first question is, a house loan is taken for rupees 1.5 crores for 5 years, and equal monthly installments are to be paid at an interest rate of 10% per annum. So there is a loan of 1.5 crores and the term is given as 5 years. Generally it is more than 5 years, and the interest rate is calculated at 10%, and the interest rate is given as per annum. This is the yearly interest rate which the bank is charging. Okay. Now we have to take out the equal monthly installment, the installment which I have to pay each month for this loan which I have taken, and the total interest amount which we'll pay, which we'll have to pay in these 5 years. So if I'm taking a loan of 1.5 crores, I'll be paying much more than that to the bank. Why? Because the rest of the amount greater than 1.5 crores is my interest payment which I'm making to the bank. So we'll start. It's a very simple function which we are going to see. This is a financial function. Now the rate which is going to be applied is 10%. So I'll write 10% over here. The year, how many years for which I'm taking the loan? I'm taking the loan for 5 years. Okay. Now what is the PV? PV is the present value. So I will just write this down over here for you all to understand. This is present value. Basically, present value is the value of the loan which I am taking now, and I am taking a loan of 1.5 crores. So I will write 1.5 crores. I'll have six zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so 1.5 crores, I have already changed it to currency. How to change it to currency? Just go, or maybe you can select rupees from here. You can select rupees from here and change it into currency. You can increase and decrease decimal if you want to. So this is 1.5 crores loan which I have taken from the bank. The years are 5 for 5 years and the interest is 10% per annum. What will be the EMI which I will have to pay to the bank? It's a simple calculation using PMT function. PMT function basically calculates the installments amount which I have to pay. This can be yearly, this can be monthly, this can be quarterly, or maybe biannually. It depends upon the data given to you and how you need to put the parameters within this. Now we have, so I am calculating EMI. In the exact same way, you have to calculate if you have to take out yearly installments or quarterly installments. Now, what is the rate at which I will be paying my installments? 10%. No, 10% is the rate per annum. This is the rate per annum. I will have to pay my installments every month, equal monthly installments. So I have to take out monthly rate. How will I take out the monthly rate? I will divide the yearly rate by 12. I will divide the yearly rate by 12. Hence, I'm dividing 10% by 12. Why am I dividing 10% by 12? Because I have to take out monthly rate. And how we take out the monthly rate? We divide the interest by 12. Okay. Now, the next thing is number of periods. N per is number of periods. Now, what is the number of period? Now, this is not 5. 5 is the number of years. But how many times you will be paying your installments? You will be paying your installments 5 into 12 times, because I am paying installments monthly and I am taking it for 5 years. So 5 into 12 is the number of period for which I'll be paying my installments. So this will be 5. See, I'm not writing 5 over here. What I'm doing is I'm selecting the cells. So this is very important for you all to understand, that we have to select the cells. Why? Because then if you change 5 to maybe 6, maybe 10, then your function will also change automatically. So when you select the cells and when you change these amounts over here, automatically your final answer changes. So this will be multiplied by 12. Okay. Now the present value is the PV over here. This remains as it is, no changes in that. The future value, the type are not for us. in this particular question. And this is also a lot of, you need to understand about a lot of financial concepts to understand what is future value and type. Now here, I have taken the rate as 10% divided by 12, number of periods as 5 multiplied by 12. If maybe you were calculating quarterly interests, now how would you take out quarterly interest? You would divide 10% by 4 because there are 4 quarters in a year. You will multiply 5 with 4 because there are 4 quarters in a year. So I will be paying quarterly installments 5 into 4 times. Okay. And then for 5 years, so 5 into 4 times. And then the present value remains the same. This is the amount. This is my EMI which I will have to pay each month to the bank. Now, why is this in red in color and why is it giving me a negative sign? This is because this is an outflow. This is what you have to pay to the bank. And when you pay something to the bank, or maybe when you show something in your accounts as that you are paying something, it is always in the red, or maybe it has a minus sign in front. So anytime you calculate, you take out, you use PMT function, you will always get an answer which is red and has a negative sign in front. Okay, now what is the total interest? So this is my equal monthly installments which I'll be paying. So I will be paying this amount for how many times? 5 into 12 times. 5 into 12 times I will be paying this amount. But how much is the loan which I had taken? I had taken 1.5 crores loan. So how will I take out the total interest which I have paid or I will pay to the bank? Simply, what you can do is, just because we have a minus sign in front, so I'm taking a minus sign again, this multiplied by 5 into, let me just select this, 5 into 12, this is the amount. Now, what is this? This is the amount basically which I will be paying to the bank in total, because this is the EMI. This is monthly installment. Monthly installment, you are paying how many times? 60 times. For 5 years, each year paying 12 times. So 5 into 12, 60 times you are paying this particular installment. Now from this installment, I will subtract the present value. Basically, this is the total amount. Suppose in a very simplified term, I am taking a loan from you, maybe of 100 rupees, and you say that pay me 5% of interest. So what is 5% of interest? 5 rupees. So in total, I will pay you 105. If I am paying you just in one single payment. So what is the amount of interest which I am paying you? 105 minus 100. So that is what we are doing here. I am taking the equal monthly installments, multiplying it with 60, because 60 times you are paying this, and minus the original loan amount which you borrowed from the bank. So this is the total interest which comes up to 41 lakhs. Let me decrease the decimal. I am rounding it down. So basically it is 41 lakhs. 22,340. This is the amount of interest which I have to pay on my loan of 1.5 crores when the interest rate is 10% and the year is 5 and I am paying my installments every month. Now you all can just simply take out any kind of installment. You all can take out quarterly installment, you all can take out yearly installments and the amount of interest which you will be paying on that particular loan. So this is how interesting it becomes. There are many other financial applications of this also. You can actually take out the entire, you can actually make the entire loan schedule, the entire loan table as to how much amount of interest and how much amount of principal payment you will do each month. But that is just out of now our topics to cover. So that is also a very good application of Excel in which you can analyze your payments to the bank. Now coming to the second question. Second question is saying that the EMI changes and increases by 10%. Calculate the number of years in which the loan will be repaid. Now, what does this mean? This means that in my EMI, this EMI which I am paying, now suppose I go to the bank and say, the bank has calculated this for me. The bank has said, this is your calculation and this will be your EMI which you have to pay each month to us. I tell to them that I am ready to pay 10% more of this particular EMI. So tell me, how much number of years will now be required to repay the loan? Obviously, it will be less than 5. It will be less than 5. Why? Because if you are paying more amount each month, you will be able to repay your entire loan of 1.5 crores early. You will be able to repay your entire loan of 1.5 crores earlier than 5 years. So I need to calculate that how many number of years are now required if my EMI increases by 10%. So what is my new EMI? What is my new EMI? This old EMI multiplied by, I can say, 1.1. And what is 1.1? Or to make it more clear to you all, 1 plus 10%. 1 plus 10%. 1 plus 10%. My earlier EMI multiplied by 1 plus 10%, increased by 10%. This is my new EMI which I have to pay. Let me change this in rupees. Or let me just keep it like that. I can change it in rupees as well. So this is my new EMI which I'll be paying to the bank. This is my new EMI which I'll be paying to the bank. Is it clear? Is this portion clear? So now, let me round this to the nearest numbers, because we generally always round the numbers when we pay the loan. So we are paying a loan of 3,50,576. Now earlier we were paying 3,18,000. Now we are paying 3,50,000. So this is the loan amount which we are paying now. Now if you are paying this amount of loan, what will be the number of years? So basically your output is changing. This is my output. This was my output. This was my output. My output is changing. My output is changing. So will my input. So will my input. So will my input. So what is the change in the input? We use this. We take out this using goal seek feature, which is a very, very important feature of Excel. Whenever your output is changing and you know the output, and you know the output, I know the output here will be 3,50,000, but I do not know my input. But I do not know my input. So how to calculate that? We calculate that using the goal seek feature. So what is the rate? The rate remains the same, which is 10%. So I will just take this as 10%. The number of years currently we know is 5. So I will be keeping this as 5 itself. The PV we have is exactly the same, which is 1,50,000. So I will be copy pasting it over here. These are my old things. 10%, 5 years and PV. PV will remain unchanged. Interest will remain unchanged. Only the number of years will change as my EMI changes. Very first step, just follow my steps and then I will explain why I'm doing this. Again, take out the PMT. So it is rate divided by 12, number of years multiplied by 12, present value. This was my, as you all can see, it's exactly the same. It's exactly the same. Let me just change this to rupees. Okay. This is exactly the same. This is exactly the same which I got in the earlier case. Exactly the same. Now, I am saying that this will change to 350,576. And what else will change with that? The number of years. So, we go to the data tab. Basically, we are manipulating our data. So, we'll go to the data tab. What if analysis, see, it's under the section forecasting. So what if analysis, goal seek, see, set cell, I've explained it over here in words. Set cell is nothing but the output cell. This is my output cell. As I said over here, this was my output and this was my input. So this is my output cell. To what value you need to change your EMI to? This is my value. So -350, do not forget the minus sign, because we have a minus sign here itself also. 350576. This is my, you have to type it down. You can't select this cell. You have to type it down, because you do not have any option to select the cell. See, this symbol over here signifies that you have an option to select a particular cell. Here you can't select a particular cell. Here you have to type it down. 350576. And what value do you want to change? What is the input which you want to change? So this is the input. This is the input which I want to change, and I want to keep my input as, I want to change my input number of years. Let me click on OK. The moment I click on OK, this has changed to 350576, and the number of years has also changed. Let me keep this to two decimal places. So it is 4.43 years. As I said, the number of years will reduce from 5. So it is now 4.43. So if you are paying 350576 installment, equal monthly installment, your number of years will reduce from 5 to 4.43 months. Or maybe you can say 4 years and 6 months, 4.5, because this will be rounded to 4.5. And 4 years, 4 years, 6 months, you will have to pay the, so 6 months has been reduced. Now, what is GoalSeek? Why do we use GoalSeek? Whenever you have the output. So I had the output already with myself. This was my target. This was my target output. This was my target output. I had my target output in hand. I did not know what will be my input value. I did not know what will be my input value. This was what I wanted to find out. This was what I wanted to find out, the input. And this was my output. This was my output. This was my output. So basically, you know the output, which is this. You know a sum. You always know the target. You always know the target output. The thing which you do not know is the input. So you need to find out the input using the GoalSeek. And always remember why I used the PMT function again over here. This is very, very, very important to understand. Why I used the PMT function over here again is because if you do not use any function, because this function involves 4.43 or year as an input. It involves year as an input. If it will not take year as an input, how will it consider this as an input? It has taken the number of years as an argument over here. As an argument over here. If it will not take this as an argument, how will it consider it to be an output? If you can simply, if you will, you could have simply written over here 350576, then by changing that value, set that value to a particular value 350576 and change the input value. But you would have got an error. Why? Because in that case, your input, how will Excel understand ki aapne yahan pe kuch input liya hai? Now to make Excel understand, you have to use a function which involves that particular input. So this is a very important point which I am writing over here. This should be a function which should involve the input as an argument. Fine. So this should involve a function. So I'm using a PMT function which includes the input, the number of years as a parameter, as a argument. And then only you can apply the GoalSeek. Otherwise, you will not be able to apply the GoalSeek. Otherwise, you will not be able to apply the GoalSeek feature. Okay. So this is how we use different. This was just a few financial application just a small, very, very, very small, tiny part of financial application which Excel can carry out. Okay, yet very interesting. You all can just go back home. You all can ask your parents about if they have any loans and what are the number of years, what is the interest which they pay. You can take out the EMI accordingly, or maybe quarterly installments, or maybe yearly installments. Okay, so this was your EMI portion and goal seek portion. Always remember that the output cell, you need to change the output cell. You know your target output. My target output was 350576, but I do not know my input. I do not know the number of years. Always in the output cell, there will be a function which will involve the use of input, and you always know the target output, but you do not know the input. You need to take out the input. So we use the goal seek feature. Okay, so this was your financial application. Moving to the very last section of our entire workshop topics, which we were to cover, macros. Now, macros again is a part of a concept. It's a part of a program called VBA, Visual Basic for Application, which is a part of Excel which automates your tasks. Whatever task you have carried out can be just done by just a click of a button. You all can just click a button and that entire task can be done using VBA. Correct? You can create large amount of reports just by clicking a button. And VBA is very much in use in companies which require tasks to be carried out every day or every month or every year. So what they do is they just create these macros, these codes, which are a part of Excel. And then just by clicking a particular button, what they do is they carry out the entire task. So this save lots and lots of manpower, lots and lots of time in doing those work. I will be covering just a small, very small portion of how you can record a very, very basic macro, how you can save it and how you can use it. Okay, so let's start. The very first thing is we need a developer tab. Now, how do we get a developer tab? Here we have the major seven tabs. These were the major seven tabs, as I've talked about. How to get the developer tab? Developer tab contains everything which is related to coding and VBA. So go to the file section. In the file section, go to the options. Go to the options. In the options, you have something as customized ribbon. You have something as customized ribbon. Click on customized ribbon. Click on customized ribbon. Here you will see developer tab also. Just tick on that. Just give a tick mark. Just give a tick mark and click on OK. In the main tab section, in the customized ribbon section, you will see the developer tab. Just give a tick mark and click on OK. Click on OK. And see, you get your developer tab here. You get your developer tab here. In the developer tab, you will see something as macros. You will see something as record macro. So I want to carry out a task, a very, very, very basic task of editing. Suppose I want to edit this particular cell. So maybe I want to change it to yellow color and keep the font color as maybe blue and let me make it bold also. Okay. So when I write something on this, then you'll see the color has been changed. Also, let me keep it as middle aligned. So four things, yellow color, blue, and the font color to be blue, the background to be yellow, bold, and middle aligned. This is what I want to do. I had to do four things separately. What if I say that just by a click of a button, this all things can be done in 1 second? So how do we do that? We use macros. So let me take my cursor somewhere over here, anywhere. Go to the developer tab, click on record macro. Click on record macro and give a name to your macro. Maybe edit one. You can give any shortcut. make sure you're not using an already existing shortcut, because already Excel uses many shortcuts. So if you use any existing shortcut, suppose Control C. So when you press this Control C, it will carry out this particular macro and it will not copy paste your things which you want to do in Excel. So do not use already existing shortcut keys, default shortcut keys which Excel uses. Make up something of your own. Suppose if I use Control E, Control Shift E, Control Shift E. So I have to type that Shift E. Control Shift E. So you have to type Control was already there. Control was already there. I just had to click on Shift plus E. Shift plus E. Nothing else. Okay. So when you write Shift plus E, it will get changed to Control Shift E. This is my new shortcut. Store the macro in this workbook. Yes. Leave it as this workbook only. Description can be edit the cell as yellow. Okay, just simple description and click on OK. The moment you click on OK, you will see that this icon over here will change. So, see, this icon over here changed, and this changed from record macro to stop recording. This means now my Excel is a record macro, recording the macro, and whatever you do in your Excel will get recorded. Whatever you do in your Excel will get recorded. So my task was to give this yellow color. So everything which I am doing, every keystrokes which I am clicking on is getting recorded. This will be changed to blue, the color, bold and middle aligned. Four things, yellow, blue I have already done, bold and middle aligned. So four things. My macro has been recorded. Go to the developer tab again. Click on stop recording. Click on stop recording. See again, the recording has stopped and now the icon has already changed to record macro. Now let me check whether this worked or not. Yes, this is fine. Now I want to check whether the macro is working or not. To use this particular, to run this macro, how do you run the macro? Go to the macros section over here. And this is the macro. So I will just keep it as this workbook. So this is the macro which I recorded, edit one. I'll click on run. Go to the macros in the developer tab, select this workbook, and here whatever name you gave to your macro, all the macros, if you have recorded more than one macro, you will see a list of the entire macro over here, and just click on edit one and click on run. Click on run. The moment you click on run, you will see the cell has been highlighted. So see, it is blue in color, bold and middle aligned. Also, you use the shortcut key Control Shift E. So let me check that whether this is working or not. So I'm clicking on Control Shift E. The moment I click on Control Shift E, see, it gets colored. This can also happen in some other sheet which you were working on. So if I take my cursor to any other sheet and click on Control Shift E, still it will work. Still it will work. Still it will work. So this is the wonder of macro. This is just a small portion. Macros are really big and you can carry out. I have already, if you can see, these are the different things which are appearing on my quick access toolbar. These are nothing but the macros which I have created for my own purpose, for my own use. And these make my task very, very, very useful. I'll just give you a small example. This is a macro which I created to unhide the sheets at once. Because in Excel, it is not possible to unhide the sheet at once. Suppose I hide this particular sheet over here. I have hidden this and I have hidden this. So I have hidden two sheets. Now how to unhide? You have to right click and click on unhide. And you have to select the sheet which you have to unhide. So I'll select sheet 1 and then click on OK. Then I'll select on sheet 8 and section 8 and then I'll click on OK. So it becomes a really big task to select one sheet separately and click on OK. So suppose this, I'm clicking on OK. Again, right click, unhide, select this and click on OK. But what if I tell you that using a macro, all the sheets can be unhidden just by a click of a button. So I click on this button. And see, all my sheets are unhidden. all my sheets are run hidden. So this is the beauty of using macros. This is the beauty of using VBA. As in my last day, I showed you all, I've used macros to create this picture scramble as well. This is the beauty of using VBA, beauty of using macros in Excel. If you're learning Excel, then it is not complete without VBA. Okay, that is a very integral part of Excel, which you also should know if you know Excel. So that was about our workshop topics, which we could not cover during the workshop. So this is a small video on that. I hope you all enjoyed our session. Do give us a feedback and do hit a like button. Thank you.